In Sir Alex Ferguson's new book, he tells the sadness about the trophy he never won, the Soccer AM Football League Trust Futsal Cup. The competition continued this week. Today, we follow Brighton.
It's very important for the kids because you touch the ball much more times than a bigger pitch. Barcelona always training in small pitches, in small areas, because then you have to think quickly. You cannot play long because the pitch is short. You have to play with passing abilities. And I think for the kids, it's very important to start playing football or futsal.
Bassier's coming in today to help. We'll give them a chance to really focus on where they would like to aspire to. And knowing someone who's played this game, get some real good information from what he can teach them and where he's got to through playing futsal.
Two current Brighton first-teamers grew up playing futsal back home in Spain.
I think I started when I was like 8, 9, but like you say, we play in the school and during the break, between the classes. We have always to run to the pitch to get a pitch and play with the friends. And as well, like we play until we pass to the bigger pitch. I was, I think, maybe 12, 13 years.
In my case, was playing in the school, and I was playing 2 games a week, 1 game with my school, futsal, and with my club, I was playing like normal football.
Look after it. Good. Check your shoulders. Game. Good.
The ball is so different, and you have to play with different parts of your feet, and I think it's really good for improve technical.
If they put clips on about Messi, about Neymar, they always saw the first clips they are about playing futsal.
We struggled really early on with understanding the technical stuff and that transition from 11-a-side to 5-a-side football. So now, I think once we've got it now, I'm really looking forward to tomorrow.
The Leighton Score Centre is just a stone's throw away from Brisbane Road and is the venue for the South East Division fixtures. The first match of the day was between Southend and Ipswich. The Shrimpers took the lead in the second half with this well-worked goal and they never looked back as they went on to win 6-3. Crystal Palace took on Leighton Orient in a top-of-the-table clash. And it was the O's who started the better of the two teams and came close to scoring with this brilliant effort. After some neat showboats, it was Orient who took the lead. But it was short-lived as Palace came back to win 3-1. Brighton played Chelsea knowing they desperately needed 3 points and they got off to the perfect start with this great effort. The floodgates then opened as Brighton managed to knock 5 past Chelsea without conceding, putting them back in the mix to qualify for the Soccer AM Cup.
Good win.
Well done, Brian. Yeah. For all the latest results and tables, or if you'd like to go along to watch your team in action, all deets and venues are on the Soccer AM website.